exercise, of course, to see if more units can work together, if the troops are compatible, if the styles are compatible. And the first answer we can give right now is yes, they are compatible. They worked very well together, and everybody who assisted today could see that this is living proof of the fact that our soldiers not only talk together, they are able, when it is necessary, to fight together.
Could they deter Russia?
Of course they could, and I think they do it.
Well, this is not a—it's not a message now for Russia. This was the decision of 28 nations last year at the NATO summit to transition from assurance to deterrence. That's an important thing to remember. 3 years ago, the last American tank went home. We had zero tanks, zero in Europe. But after Russia's invasion of Ukraine and illegal annexation of Crimea, then the security environment changed. And so the United States, under the previous administration, said that we have to bring equipment back over here. And so everybody, Romania, Poland, all the allies have worked very hard to meet the political guidance that we received from our leaders. Thousands of soldiers from 20 different countries, all coming to the Black Sea region, rail, convoy, air, ships, every possible means of conveyance. We have to practice. You have to practice that. So that was extremely important. And then the infrastructure necessary, where do you put 20,000 soldiers and everything that they need, the amount of ammunition that you saw today, that doesn't come through the mail. You have to have a system that delivers it, the maintenance for vehicles. I mean, that is all hard stuff.